Is she here yet?
Not yet, ma'am, no.
Then she's late.
Yes, she is late.
Your Royal Highness.
When Kristen walked on a set as Princess Diana, it was almost like, you know, she was channeling her.
And action!
What I thought was wonderful about the script is it didn't appear to be a straight biopic.
I loved that script. You know, I read it and literally finished it and then started it again.
Honestly, the script is so well written. It's so well drawn. There is a lot of material to sift through.
And that's what you do. You watch.
I watch to make sure that others do not see.
Knowing Pablo and his work, and you in the hands of a master like him, we were going to get an entirely different look.
Pablo is lovely. He's loved by, I think, every one of us.
His preparation for it, the thought, it's like he's thought of everything.
I love the way that Pablo works. I love how on my toes I feel. You know, Pablo will do these things that you'll shoot a scene and you'll suddenly find yourself, he will just totally throw you in at the deep end doing something else without having warned you, without having, and you'll suddenly find yourself doing something completely different. And I love that kind of work because it makes you do things that you didn't know you could.
It was a mixture of incredibly organized and disciplined, but also very, very inventive.
It's so beautiful because you have a Latin American director with an American actress in Germany with a half British and mostly German crew making a movie about a British icon. We were very, very lucky to have such an incredible cast.
Pablo called me one day and said, I think we should go for Kristen Stewart. Very good actress, I knew she was excellent. Could this very American young woman, actually the same age as Diana, could she play this iconic British character?
I'm looking for somewhere. I have absolutely no idea where I am.
So the question was, can she get the accent? You know, that was a big, big deal. If she can't do the accent, we're dead.
Beautiful, but not very bright. Did you read the Vogue article about me?
Kristen's first day of dialogue, I was desperate to hear a British accent to see how she was doing. And I was absolutely stunned. She must have worked so hard.
It's the past, the present, the future.
Right.
Well, here, there is only one tense. There is no future. Past and the present are the same thing.
It's an incredibly brilliant performance.
Look, emergency way, looks beautiful. It doesn't fit.
Have you tried it on?
No, with my mood. It doesn't fit with my mood.
She mastered the art of perfecting the personality of Diana.
And it's not an impersonation, but this is an embodiment.
She is a wonderful person and a wonderful actress. She is a total joy to work with.
This experience opened me up in a completely new way. Kind of like filled me with this new confidence as a woman. As soon as I really got to know her and sort of like built a relationship with her, I just felt like every single day we were going there to protect her in some way.
How do I look?
You look fine.
She's at a breaking point, I think. Her feelings and her individual desires and also her failure in some way to change their attitudes to her, I think, and towards what she was hoping it might be like. It's an investigation of how she's going to survive, given that she's in this immutable world that cannot be changed. Diana had this undoubted, genuine love in her heart.
She just managed to connect with people in a way that people might not expect from a member of the royal family. And people suddenly felt like they could reach her and they could see her and she saw them back.
She represents someone that was very regular and people could feel that they were her. And that idea of empathy that she had is very impressive. And I think people still relate to her.
I've left a coat in my car. I want you to clean it, sew it up, whatever it needs. Coat from where, Mum? Ancient history. Who's ancient history? Spencer.
You're looking through a keyhole and seeing an imaginary interpretation of somebody struggling who comes from clearly the modern world with this very established tradition, and seeing these interesting characters whose survival depends on them holding this tradition together.
Her Majesty herself just a second ago sat on these scales. And she was very insistent that everyone joins in. They said, no one is above tradition.
It's a survival story, and it's like a woman drowning and thrashing and then finally coming up on shore and taking that very successful gasp.
It's a story of female repression and empowerment. It feels like what's going on in society with various repressed elements in society shouting, crying out for help and liberation. We think this story contributes to the voices of women being heard around the world.
People will make assumptions about this. It's not just about the royal family, it is, but it also is about something that is emotional and strong and about individuality.
I was so nervous at the beginning, but I was nervous because I cared a lot and also because I really enjoyed it.
I think as soon as the movie starts, something happens, you fall into the poetry of it.
I think they can look forward to something different. I think they can look forward to something unlike anything that they might have seen on this subject before.
It's very, very impressive and very, it's great to be a part of it, you know.
Help!
Diana, for the good of the country.
Of the country. You know, I really like things that are simple, ordinary, but things that are real. There's no hope for me, not with them. Fight them. You are your own weapon.
Will they kill me, do you think?